some way overdue, very preliminary thoughts on the second biggest issue for humanity. The first two tied being bringing right-wing Israel under control and preventing the destruction of life support on planet Earth. But the second, and without those two major impending disasters, then the first. Is how to parent. I wouldn't be sitting here in front of the White House on such a journey that's so radically different from what our society calls for had I not had two biological offspring 3 decades or so ago. That brought a focus to my life. It was quantum, more intense, more healthy, more serious of purpose than I had before, thank God. The saying is, the child is the father to the man, and what that means, I think in most significant part, is that we become who we're supposed to be when we realize that our purpose is to bring up children. That certainly was a major part of my advancement and growth. And I realized that I knew not a fraction of what I needed to know, that what I knew and didn't know that I needed to know was going to have a dramatic impact, for good or for bad, on those two biological offspring. And I wanted and want with every fiber of my being to be as constructive an influence as any breath that I take will enable me to be and to become. I was judged by many to be among the best fathers that they had seen, and I think that was probably correct. But what I've learned in the last 10 years, what I've learned in the last 10 months as things have come together and crystallized, would have made me, as measured by what my offspring needed, a 3 on a scale of 1 to 10, or a minus 2 on a scale of minus 5 to plus 5. A plus 3 or a plus 4. There's much more thought and work that I hope I'm given time to do on this. But what I'll share now is that the central issues are, do you want to do what I did, which is basically to bring up an aflaholic, or excuse me, aflaholics, as I was, to live in a world comfortably of aflaholics, the vast majority Western world, or for your children, do you want to bring them up in the immense minority world of being alcoholism free? There are two potential addictions, and we can't escape both. We're going to be addicted to one or the other. Alcoholism, that is a overwhelming craving for our own affluence, superiority, comfort, pleasure, intoxications. Or loving servants of our neediest brothers and sisters as the healthy tissue and members of every other species besides ours are. It's what we're designed to do. We have enough intellect to have figured out the way of cancer, self-service. I didn't understand that question. I could now go to Start Loving 4 YouTube channel and see one of the featured playlists, which is something like What Waging Love Looks Like, or What Insane Humanity Being Insanely Humane Looks Like. And I would not marry unless I had a partner, and I would not have children unless I had a partner that with me was joined in taking the immensely difficult and only path, which is to raise a child that is, by today's standards, insanely humane and would belong with the insanely humane brothers and sisters, the one in a million of us that has escaped becoming a afloholic droid, a slave to afloholism. That's really the central unifying concept of so many other things that I could say. To repeat one of them, it would be, if I brought a child into the world, if I had responsibility, direct responsibility for a child, I would devote everything I had and everything I knew to addicting them to loving, to addicting them to waging love. No, to maintaining the addiction that they're born with to loving, to waging love. That's what we're designed to do. And to place them in environments, construct environments that were as free as possible of the afloholic influences and seductions, and as rich as possible in the seductions of loving. Almost impossible. But if I didn't do it, I'd be raising an afloholic, of which alcoholism is just a subset, and a much less dangerous subset because it's much less insidious, particularly in this culture. It's much easier to see and therefore to block. It's such an important topic. There's so much more I need to say. There's so much more thought that I need to give prior to doing so, but it won't deviate in direction from what I've just shared, and time being of the essence, I needed to share that.